guys, prepare for some bitching incoming. Alright, so this is basically a video made on the feedback which I'm getting from you guys. Probably you are guessing correctly, I'm getting tons of messages every day, right? And that's fine, I love to help the guys, I love being engaged and I love your emails, that's not the problem. But guys, it is becoming more and more kind of obvious that some of you do not deserve to have AK. Maybe not deserve, but they are not ready to have AK rifle. First of all, a lot of complaints about the recoil, and we talk about it. Guys, the way to curb the recoil, the basic way is, of course, to address the problem with the muzzle device. If you put the good muzzle brake, you will curb down that recoil. And I understand, when you're switching from AR-15 5.56 round, it is a big jump to 7.62x39, especially a lot of basic setups, and they are very often those budget AKs, they are overguessed. That's the price you have to pay for a reliability, and that's kinda normal, okay? I'm not saying that every AK should be overguessed, but usually they are. If you're going down, if you drill down to the budget AKs, they will be probably overguessed. But then you can control it with the muzzle device, as I said, or you can have some fancy gas block, which is with adjustable positions and everything, or KNS precision piston, things like this. You can address the overguessing, honestly, and address the recoil. Another thing what a lot of you is complaining is my front post is canted. Guys, as long as you can zero the rifle, it's pretty much okay. Most likely when you're buying, again, the budget AKs, your front post will be canted. And you may not know this, but even on the basic M4, this M4A1, right, some of them are canted as well, but because you have the rear side adjustable for the windage, you don't even notice this, right? So this is not the problem isolated to the AKs only. This is just the way how you are adjusting the windage on the AK, it's more obvious. So yes, some of them will be canted. Some of them are horribly canted, and that's unfortunate. That's a sloppy manufacturing. But as I said, when you're paying that budget price, do not expect miracle. My cutout point is, like, if I'm paying in that $1,000 neighborhood for the AK, I do expect to have the sides front post really straight, right? Because for me, $1,000, it's a lot of money. For some, maybe not, but for me, it's a lot of money. So for me, this is like cutout point. At that price point, I do expect to have the sides really straight. Now, if you're buying the budget AK, you have to realize that probably your sights will be canted. Deal with it, or do not get AK. That's what I said. Some of you do not deserve or are not ready for their AK. Another third point is, a lot of you is complaining about it is hard to accessorize it. Or maybe it's not too hard to accessorize it, but the accessories do not fit like they fit the AR-15s. Yes, you have to be somehow handy with the parts, and most likely when you're buying the accessories for the AK, be prepared that some minor fitting will be required. Guys, this is, that goes without saying. It is AK, there is very loose standard, and we are getting a lot of different breeds of AKs into the United States, or even US made AKs are, made from like all over the places, right? Because of the parts kits and things like this. So some fitting will be required. If you are not handy with the basic tools, I strongly recommend, please walk away from the AK. This is not the rifle for you. If you are not really willing to put up some work, get your fingers dirty, and it's absolutely fine. I'm not criticizing you. I understand that, you know, with AR, most likely like AR-15, standard is pretty much set and you know what you're buying. With AK, that's not the situation, that's not the reality. But get ready, if you jumping into the AK, that some parts will require some fitting, and you have to really be kind of, you know, like you have to have a little bit of willingness and work on it to make it fit. But on the other hand, I think that that's a great thing about it, right? You have to get better with the tools, and you gotta make it work. So it's more interesting, at least for me. Okay, that's why I like AK so much. It's always a challenge. But that being said, look at this AK, for example. It's completely pimped. You got the optic, you got the M4 stock adapter with adjustable cheek riser and everything, and you can make it work. You can make it work, and I'm having just the flash hider here. There's absolutely no recoil on this Definitive Arms AK. So you can make them work and they will be just fine. Or keep it simple like we got here, basic setup, and it's fun to shoot, and you can have tons of blast with it. Is it as easy as this, you know, as I said, M4 A1? No, it is not. You know, but that's some trade-off. You're trading some things, and they will require from you a little bit more interaction with the firearm. But I think so that's why people like the AK so much, because they are making you involved much more than with AR-15s. So that's my basic point. Like, if you are thinking about jumping into the AK, be prepared for some basic things which are not going to be as smooth and easy as it was on AR-15. There are some challenges to be addressed, and that rifle will ask you much more, even from the shooting point of view. The 7.62x39, it's a much more challenging round than the 5.56x45. If you jump into the 74 type of AKs, that's a totally different ballgame. That's cartridge much more closer to the AR-15 5.56. But if you're using the 7.62x39, this is much more challenging for shooting. But I can guarantee you, if you work on this rifle, and if you will work on your fundamentals and everything, it will pay off on any cartridge you're working down the line. All right, that's it. That's kind of, you know, end of the rant from Rob. So if you're thinking to jumping into the AK world, fine, I absolutely applaud the decision, but be ready to put up some work. This is not the Lego blocks, this is not the Lego system. It will require you to work on it, but then the satisfaction is much more greater, and that's why we love AKs. Thanks for watching, guys. Thanks for supporting AK Operators Union.